Welcome to the Apostolate's Peace of Heart Forum Classic Series, where hundreds of key personalities in the Church share insights and wisdom from classic spiritual literature. These experts are interviewed by the Apostolate's founder from a unique family perspective so that the spiritual insights shared can be applied to our everyday lives and give us peace of heart. Let's now join the discussion.
I'm Jerry Conacher. Just want to welcome you to an opening program now on a series that we're going to be doing on Cardinal Lorenzi's book, Trust in Divine Providence. Cardinal Lorenzi is here today. He's the author, and he's also prefect of the Congregation for Divine Worship and the Discipline of the Sacraments. And Your Eminence, before we start this book, can we open with a prayer, please?
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Lord God, You created us. You have a plan for every one of us. Every detail of our lives enters into Your plan. Help us to believe in Your love for us and in Your care for us, and to live as loving children so that we may attain the purpose for which You created us. This we beg of You through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Mary, Mother of Good Counsel, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Well, Your Eminence, a lot is packed in this little book, and it's very, very powerful. We start off with the introduction, the origins of this book.
Yeah, the origin of it really is this. Many people who believe in God, and they believe that God loves us, but there are many questions. They have no answers to those questions. Mm-hmm. They are puzzled. For example, they see so much evil.
Yes.
They see suffering. Also, they are asking relationship between the will of God and human freedom.
Mm-hmm.
They have asked me from time to time for explanations. For example, they have seen earthquakes,
yes,
disasters, okay, flooding,
all the suffering, yeah,
drought,
mm-hmm,
HIV, AIDS, attacking even little children that have done no harm.
Yes.
And they ask, why? The 20th century has recorded two world wars,
yes,
the Holocaust, the killing fields of Cambodia in the 70s, the My Lai massacre during the Vietnam War, the ex-Yugoslavia so-called ethnic cleansing,
mm-hmm,
the Rwandan inter-ethnic massacres, and many other wars besides.
Yes.
So people ask, how do we explain that? They are distressed to see innocent people suffering,
that's
or even
right,
a little child being sick.
Yes.
Not that they want old people to get sick, but it is more puzzling to see a little child who gets cancer,
mm-hmm,
or who has AIDS from contacted from someone around.
Mm-hmm.
Also, they see people who eat themselves to sickness or who drug themselves to death.
Yes.
Although we are sorry for them, we have compassion for them, it is still more painful when you see the mother of seven who dies of cancer when the children are still young, or you see a super scientist of the first class, mm-hmm, returning from his studio, he is killed by a drunken teenager who is returning from a discotheque.
Yes.
You just imagine that.
Mm.
What a loss for humanity. So people ask, why? Moreover, they ask why life is so short, why a businessman, a professor, a technocrat, a major contributor to economy is truncated by one disease or the other. People ask why. In any case, why do we die at all?
Mm-hmm.
With all that we have accumulated of wisdom,
yes,
and experience. Then there are also minor cases of suffering.
Mm-hmm.
A young person fails an examination. You are going to catch a bus, and while you are reaching there, the bus moves.
Yes.
So you don't succeed. Or your aircraft is overbooked, and they didn't take you, mm-hmm, Yes. Although you had an okay ticket.
Yeah, just like coming here.
And then everything you prepared at the other end seems to go upside down. Or simply, you didn't succeed in getting to the university of your choice. Or it rains on the day you prepared a picnic.
Yes.
Or your school had a big American football, you know, competition, and your school lost.
Right.
Ah, well. In the face of other disasters we mentioned before, these are not of the same size.
Yes.
Nevertheless, they do cause some inconvenience.
Mm-hmm.
So people ask, where does divine providence begin and where does it finish?
Yes.
Where can we see the hand of God in all that? This is a sort of state of the question.
That's true.
Which I wanted to reflect upon with the readers.
What is divine providence? This is really a book. The whole book defines it. That's right.
Yes, we will soon do that.
Mm-hmm.
But we will have to ask, what is the aim of these reflections? Lest you seek from them more than they can offer.
Mm-hmm.
The aim is simply to provide simple spiritual help that will be of guidance to a sincere believer in the existence of God, to accompany the follower of Christ in reflecting on this dimension of our faith in accordance with the teaching given us in Holy Scripture by the saints and by the teaching authority of the church.
Yes.
As far as the human mind can understand, and also to see how much we can know by reason before ever we go to revelation. It is not the aim of this booklet to get into deep philosophical research, nor to grapple with classical theological questions on predestination, free will, and God's omnipotence. That means the theologians that could ask, if God knows all the choices people would make, where does grace come in?
Yeah.
If Judas Iscariot did not get his 30 coins and betray our Lord, how then would we have been saved?
Yes.
Well, these are big theological questions that this booklet does not intend to go into. It just intends to examine the rough and tumble problems of daily life which people have to battle with.
That's right.
And some of the reasons that make people not to grow so much in the spiritual life. I have seen priests, even religious sisters, brothers, who could have been much greater saints. But because of their attitude towards divine providence, they have remained spiritual dwarfs.
Yes.
They have not grown much.
So they haven't accepted God's will in these areas.
Not entirely. They have accepted God's will up to a point, but not beyond that point. So they do not grow as fast as they could.
Yes.
If they took the full plunge of accepting God's will, sign your name at the bottom of the page and give the page to God. Leave the whole thing blank and allow him to write whatever he writes. He likes there.
No,
they hesitate to do that.
But it's not telling us not to have initiative, not to have drive.
That will be mentioned too.
Yes, right.
But we must trust God.
Yes.
And not say to God, I will not sign my name until you write everything so that I look at it first before I sign. Which means you don't trust him 100%.
Well, you listened to Gwen's final words before she died and how she said, I trust that he'll be there when me at the end. You know,
that is the attitude of a Christian.
Yeah.
So you asked me, what is divine providence?
Yeah.
That's chapter 1,
right.
On page 1. Because we have to be clear what we are talking about. We can, in brief, define divine providence as, you know, God himself considered in the act by which in his wisdom he has ordered everything. Everything is created in good order. And he has a plan for everything and therefore a plan for every human being. Not only for human beings has God a plan. He has a plan for trees, for stones, for deserts, but more so, he has a plan for us humans who have intellect and will.
Now that's an unrepeatable plan. I mean, nobody else is going to replace us in fulfilling that plan.
It's just for that individual.
Yeah.
And every one of us is an individual.
Right.
God's plan for me is not God's plan for you.
That's what makes people special.
Yes.
Very special.
And God knows each of us by name, mm-hmm. one by one. He doesn't forget any of us. So that's divine providence.
Yes.
Now, to believe that and to live it is the whole point of this book.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there are some basic truths which are necessary if we are to accept divine providence.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it looks very ordinary to say that God exists.
Yes.
But if you didn't accept that, then the rest of the book doesn't arise.
Right. Right. I mean, this is the first step.
Mm-hmm.
Without that foundation, we have nothing.
But not only that God exists,
mm-hmm.
but that God does influence reality. To most people, it's obvious that God exists and has a purpose in creating everything.
Mm-hmm.
But there are those we call deists. Deists are those who hold that God exists.
Yeah.
But they say he has no contact with human affairs.
Yeah, we call it deists, yes.
Uh-huh.
Right.
Mm-hmm. That God exists but has no contact with human affairs.
I see. Just lets us work it out ourselves.
Yeah, they accept the existence of a supreme being who is regarded as ultimate source of reality.
Mm-hmm.
But they don't regard him as intervening in natural or historical processes in human affairs
mm-hmm.
by way of particular providence or revelation
mm-hmm.
or salvation.
Yes.
Shall we accept that? No, we shall not. We don't accept that. Because God, it would be a contradiction to say that God exists, that he created us, but he does not look after us.
Mm-hmm.
Because that looking after what he has created is part of creation. It is a type of continued creation,
right.
keeping in existence and directing to their end what he has made.
Mm-hmm.
More radical than deists are atheists, those who deny the existence of God.
Altogether. So they,
yes.
don't believe in any God.
Our reply to them is very right. brief. God is the one being who of his very nature exists and must exist. God contains in himself the entire reason for his own existence. God does not owe his existence to any other being
mm-hmm.
beyond himself.
He's the unmoved mover.
Yes.
Same.
To anyone who understands the meaning of the word, God, the word God, it is a contradiction in terms to say that God does not exist. Because everything else that exists is a contingent being.
Mm-hmm.
That means a being that may exist or not exist. If then it does exist, it is because of another being mm-hmm. that made it to exist.
Right.
And that other being that made it to exist, which is not made to exist by any other being,
mm-hmm.
is God.
Right.
So any good philosopher knows that much. Deists. We will really answer this by the rest of this booklet.
Mm-hmm.
Those who say that God does not interact in human affairs, their answer is the whole booklet.
Okay.
The answer is there is divine providence.
Yes, God does interact with
uh-huh.
us. Yes.
So little by little, we will be giving them answers.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end, we will ask them, are you still holding your position?
Yes. Because most people don't even realize what the word deist is anymore, but
uh-huh.
I think you defined it very nicely.
Then, first of all, we must know that God is indeed the first cause. But he's not the only cause.
Mm-hmm.
The things God created, he also enables them to effect something.
Mm-hmm.
So everything is not effected by God directly.
Right.
The philosophers say it this way, that God is the first cause of all things.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing happens that he has not willed or permitted.
Yes.
Because there are some things that happen
that are evil and he doesn't will
that
evil.
Are evil. God did not want them,
right.
but he permitted them.
Yes.
Yeah. If Judas sold Christ for 30 coins, that's a bad act.
Yes.
God did not will that, but he permitted it. and he used it for our salvation.
He always draws good from evil in some way.
Yeah, so we have to make approach very carefully. In his goodness, God has created various orders of things and has endowed each of them with a purpose. Mm-hmm. A tree, a stone, which is not alive, a tree, which is alive, a chicken, a dog, a chimpanzee. You see, increasing degree of sophistication than the human being.
Mm-hmm.
You see, each with a purpose. He has willed that things will act as secondary causes.
Yes.
Some of them will act necessarily. Some of them will act freely, according to the nature he gave them. Mm-hmm. A stone can cause, but only in a secondary way, and necessarily.
Mm-hmm.
So if you lift a stone and take away your hand, the stone will fall.
Yes.
Now, if there's anybody below, the stone will fall there.
Yes.
And the stone does so necessarily. Mm-hmm. It cannot choose.
Right.
If it is a human being, you tell him to jump. He can decide to jump at the right or at the left.
Right.
Because he has free will.
Right.
So his is not necessarily. According to the nature, therefore, that God gave that being. Thus, according to God's creative wisdom and goodness, stones and trees act necessarily. Cats and dogs act by instinct.
Mm-hmm.
So a dog, you see, is superior to a tree.
Yes.
Some dogs can be so trained that when the master says, come, they come.
Yes.
I have seen a dog so trained by the master that the master brings meat, puts it in front of the dog and says, don't touch it.
Mm-hmm.
And the dog does not touch it.
No, I believe that.
When the master says, now take it, the dog takes it.
Mm-hmm.
So that dog has been trained.
Yes.
That's better than a tree.
Yes.
But instinct still.
Mm-hmm.
Don't tell me the dog is intelligent.
Right.
But the dog comes very near.
Mm-hmm.
The chimpanzee comes very near. I visited in Singapore a big museum, and there was a chimpanzee there. And the chimpanzee, if you pay a fee, you sit near the chimpanzee and take a photograph.
Mm-hmm.
You can have tea with the chimpanzee. The chimpanzee pours the tea for you and brings with a little teaspoon. You want sugar? One cube, two cubes.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's great.
Yeah.
That's coming nearer.
Yeah.
But the human being is above them all.
Right.
The human being has intelligence and free will.
And we're not promoting evolution here.
Certainly not. But we are just stating the fact that God created
all
various grades of being.
That's right.
Uh-huh. This will help us to appreciate our role.
Mm-hmm.
Because some people say, if God has determined it, where is my freedom?
Right.
Ah, take it easy. When we say divine providence, we mean this ordering of things to their end according to their nature.
Yes.
God, therefore, decides to make use of means.
Mm-hmm.
But he is also free to decide otherwise. He can suspend the laws of nature and work a miracle if he wishes.
Yes.
As Jesus, when he walked on the Sea of Galilee, and he turned six pots of wine into six jars of excellent wine. Oh, six pots of water into six pots of excellent wine. He can do that, but that is a miracle.
Yes. And this parting of the Red Sea for Moses, this was...
That's a miracle.
Yes.
Yes, the water stood high.
Yes.
When the people of Israel had passed, God made the waters to take their normal position.
Yeah, and there goes Pharaoh's army.
Uh-huh. So God is free.
Yeah.
The creation is his.
Mm-hmm.
The human being, then, is the masterpiece of God's visible creation.
Yes.
That is, I say visible to exclude the angels, because they are superior to human beings.
Yes.
But of all the things we can see in this world, stones, trees, dogs, cats, chimpanzees, human being, the human being is the highest of them.
Yes.
And that's the one that interests us most.
Mm-hmm.
God has gifted the creature, human being, with intelligence and free will. The human being is more than a thing. He is a person with individuality. He or she is a person with individuality. Obviously, God has a purpose in creating us.
Mm-hmm.
human beings. Even natural philosophy can arrive at the truth that the human being is created for truth, for beauty, mm-hmm. for happiness. God does not fail to endow man with means to reach this end in a way fitting for an intelligent and free person who is body and soul. I say man, meaning whether man or woman. I will not say he or she every time.
Right, right. But even Aristotle figured these things out, and these great thinkers.
Yes.
Figured it out there.
A good philosopher figures out all that.
Through logic, they came at there had to be an unmoved mover.
That is true.
they
that is true. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You can see that all this is going to lay foundation for divine providence.
Yes.
Because Christian revelation allows us to know more about God, mm-hmm. that he raised the human being to supernatural state, that the Father sent his only Son as a savior of the world, that we are called to eternal happiness, mm-hmm. and therefore that God made me to know him, to love him, to serve him in this world, and to be happy with him forever in the next. Mm-hmm. So divine providence wants man to reach this final end, to reach heaven, through the circumstances of daily life.
Yes.
So God uses his goodness, wisdom, and omnipotence to see that all things will result for good for those who love him.
Mm-hmm.
That is divine providence.
That's divine providence. That's beautiful. Well, I think this we're just journeying through this book of Francis Card Lorenzi, and the word trust in divine providence is so key. Do we really trust in God's plan for our life? And one of the truths that the Cardinal is talking about, God has a unique plan for each one of us, and that's what Pope John Paul said. That gives us that dignity. No one can duplicate what we're called to do. That does make us special in the eyes of God. It humbles us because it's his plan, not our plan, and we have to be open to his plan. I know Mother Teresa was a certain perfect example of trusting in divine providence. So we just want to thank you, and if you want information on this book, just call us at the number on the screen or visit our website, familyland.org. God bless you all.